Hello everyone, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Welcome back. We have a topic today for the day is Altman Z Score. I mean, this name itself is gonna sound to you as if like it's something really complicated. Don't worry, we make simple things, we make complicated things more simple. Well, you have a formula here. 1.2 into work cap divided by total assets, 1.4 divided by some of the formula, and it's been put up till the end. We have a ton of details here. No issues. We'll try and understand this. See, the Altman Z score, it is a type of a Z which was published by Sir Edward Altman in 1968. As Z-score formula, which was used to predict the chances of the bankruptcy. So this methodology can be used to predict the chances of the business organization to move into bankruptcy. Okay, so this is the reason within a given time, and which is mostly about loosely 2 years of time span. So this method is successful in predicting the status of the financial distress. Whatever financial distress is there, you know, it can be predicted in any firm. An Altman Z score, you know, it can help in measuring the financial health of a business organization by the use of the multiple balance sheet values and corporate incomes. So what this formula is all about. Okay, the formula of Altman Z score, it is basically designed for publicly held manufacturing firms with a value more than $1 million. Of $1 million in terms of the net worth. So the five financial ratios that is used in calculation of the Altman Z score formula are A, the working capital divided by the total assets. Then we have B in here lined up as retained earnings divided by the total assets. We have earning before interest tax, interest and the tax payment divided by the total assets. D, we have the equity market value divided by the total assets. So retained earning, total assets, everything is compared to total asset, working cap, retained earnings, EBIT and equity market value. And E, that's the final thing, that's the total sales divided by the total assets that will be divided. So the Altman Z score formula for the model for determining the probability that a firm to close the bankruptcy. Here, 1.2 into A, that was the working capital, into B, into C, into D and E. Okay. So in this model, if the Z value is greater than 2.99, the Z value over here, if it is greater than 2.99, then the firm is said to be in the safe zone. Okay, it is considered in the safe zone and has a negligible probability of filing bankruptcy. Now, if the Z value is between, let's say, 2.99 and 1.81, then the firm is said to be in the what we call as the gray zone. Okay, and has a moderate probability for bankruptcy. And finally, the Z value below, that is less than 1.81, then it is said to be in the distress zone and has a very high probability of reaching the stage of what we call as bankruptcy. Now, let's do the application part of Altman Z score in predicting the bankruptcy. See, the value of the Altman Z score is generally found around minus 2.5 or 0.25 for the firms that have been the highest probability of going bankrupt. And on the other hand, for the firm that is least probability of facing the bankruptcy, the value of the Altman Z score is as high as 4.4. Second, you know, the Altman Z score formula is helpful for investors to determine if they should consider buying a stock or sell some of the stocks than they have. Then generally the Altman Z score below 1.8 denotes that the firm is under the chance of getting into bankruptcy. On the other hand, the firm with the Altman Z score greater than 3 are assumed to be less likely to go bankrupt. So an investor can decide to buy a stock if the Altman Z score is closer to 3 or greater than 3. And similarly, they can decide to sell a stock if the value is closer to 1.8 or less than 1.8. Now, if you see in 2007, the specific asset securities had been given higher credit rating than they must have been. So however, the companies were correctly predicted to be increased in their financial risk and should have been heading on towards the bankruptcy lineup. If you see, the Altman calculated that the median Altman Z score for the firms in 2007 was 1.81. So this company's credit ratings were the same as that of the financial ratio of B, which is used for the formula in Z. So this indicates that this indicated that in the almost half of the companies are being rated lower, and they were extremely distressed and had a high level of likelihood of reaching the stage of bankruptcy. Therefore, the Altman Z-score calculation led him to believe that, you know, the crisis would occur and there would be a meltdown, what we call as, you know, credit market. So Altman believed that the crisis would stem from the company's defaults. Now, however, the meltdown began from the mortgage-backed down securities, that's the MBS, and still the firm shortly defaulted in 2009, the second higher rate in the history, as predicted by the Altman. Now, Altman Z score's for private firms. If you see for the private firms, the origin of the Altman Z score formula is modified to fit in the case of the private firms, and the business ratio in the case are, you know, A, that is the current assets less the current liability divided by TA, total assets. In case of B, we know retained earnings divided by TA, total assets. In case of C, we had EBIT divided by the TA, total assets. Then D, we have the book value BV of equity divided by the total liability. And E, finally, that is the sales divided by the TA. Right, so the actual Altman Z score formula for this model for determining the probability for a firm to close bankruptcy is over here. You'll multiply this 0.717, 0.717, over here 0.847, over here 3.107, 0.420, and 0.989 for the private firms. And in this model, if the Z value over here, if it is greater than 2.99 and 1.23, then in that scenario, the firm is said to be in the what we discussed as the gray zone and has a moderate chance of the bankruptcy. And the finally, if the Z value is below, if it is less than 1.23, then it is said to be in the distress zone and has a very high level of probability of reaching the stage of the bankruptcy. Now, how about we see the Altman Z score for the non-manufacturing firm developed in the emerging market? So the original Altman Z score formula is slightly modified to be used in case of the firms that are non-manufacturing and operating in the emerging markets. So we use only the four financial ratios in this model. The four financial ratios are A, current assets minus current liabilities divided by total assets. We have retained earnings divided by total assets. EBIT, finally, the book value. We'll deduct the sales part. The actual Altman Z score over here is going to be for non-manufacturing firms 6.56, 3.26, 6.72 and 1.05. The actual formula of Altman Z score formula for this model for determining the probability for non-manufacturing firms, you know, operating in the emerging markets to file a bankruptcy in this particular format. You multiply this with A and B. So in this model, the Z value is greater than, if it is greater than 2.6, then in that particular scenario, the firm is said to be in the safe zone and the negligible probability of filing a bankruptcy. Now, if the Z score is between 2.6 to 1.1, then the firm is said to be in the what we call as the gray zone and has a moderate chance of bankruptcy. And if the Z value is, let's say, below 1.1, then it is said to be in the distress zone and has a very high probability of reaching the stage of bankruptcy. So after discussing all of this, let me give you my final conclusion on this. The Altman Z score is widely used metric with the wide application, and it is one of the several credit marking models already in use that combines the quantifiable of the financial indicator with a small range of variables, which will help us to predict whether or not the firm will financially fail or go into bankruptcy. You know, however, over the years, since it is the introduction of the Z score has been improved to become one among the reliable predictor for the bankruptcy, and many analysts nowadays use this method above any other because of its wide application. In fact, once Altman re-evaluated the strategies, you know, by examining the 86 distressed firms in 1969 to 1975. And then to 110 bankrupt firms, that was between 1976 to 1955, and later closely to 120 firms from 1996 to 1999. So the Z score has been accurately leveled between 82% to 94%, which was more than that achieved by any of the methodologies that existed. However, the garbage in, garbage out motto applies here as well, because therefore, you know, if a firm's financial or the input data are misleading or incorrect, then the z-score will go wrong and will not be helpful at all our analysis and the prediction is and the prediction for the bank.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.